Hi children, today we'll study about rotational revolution of the earth. What we will learn about two moments of the earth and effects of the earth's movements. Introduction. Earlier, people believed that the earth was at the center of the solar system and the sun moved around the earth. However, scientists like Nicolaus Copernicus and Galileo Galilei proved the sun is at the center of the solar system and the earth moves around the sun. Movements of the earth. The sun is at the center of the solar system and has a fixed position. Then how do we see the sun rise and set in the sky? This happens because of the earth's movement around the sun. The earth exhibits two types of movements, rotation and revolution. Rotation. Earth rotates or spins around its axis. An axis is the imaginary line joining the North Pole and the South Pole. North Pole is the extremely last part of the Northern Hemisphere. Similarly, the South Pole is the extremely the last point of the Southern Hemisphere, the Earth. If you are enjoying this video, please give a like, share, comment, subscribe. Let's go back to the topic. An equator is the horizontal line on the earth which divides the earth approximately into two equal parts. The northern part of the equator is called the northern hemisphere. The southern part of the equator is called the southern hemisphere. Day and night. We know that the earth receives light and heat from the sun. The side of the earth facing the sun will experience day and the side not facing the sun will experience night time. It is due to the rotation of the earth that we see the sun rise in the east and set in the west. Revolution. Revolution is the second type of motion of the earth. It is the movement of the earth around the sun in a fixed path or orbit. Revolution causes the change of seasons. It takes 365 days and 6 hours. It is also 1 year to revolve around the sun. If you like any seasons, please comment it down below. Seasons. The Earth's revolution not only affects but actually causes the temperature conditions that give us spring, summer, fall, and winter seasons. Which season it depends on whether you live in the northern or southern hemisphere, because the earth's axis tilts towards one of the two as it moves around the sun. The seasons are always opposite in each hemisphere. This rotational process causes the sun to be higher in the sky in the winter and lower in the summer. The day when the northern hemisphere is tilted towards the sun most, it is called summer solstice. It occurs on 21st June. On 22nd December, people experience winter solstice when the northern hemisphere is tilted the most away from the sun. On 23rd September, the earth experiences autumn equinox. And on 21st March, it is spring equinox. Solstice means unequal length of day and night. And equinox means equal length of day and night. Thank you. Bye, cyborgs.